हेलो। सर आम स्टार्ट करवा मु जस्ट गोटे वेलकम कर दूची तापर स्टार्ट करवा जड़े लर्नर अच्छा तापर आम लर्नर जॉइनिंग करते शेष तो वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेलकम टू ऑल दिस आवर वंडरफुल सेशन टुडे आवर रिसर्च पर्सन्स डॉक्टर प्रदीप कुमार प्रधान एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर गंगाधर मेहर यूनिवर्सिटी संबलपुर एंड टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज डाटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम इन अकाउंटिंग तो आई वेलकम एंड रिक्वेस्ट टू आवर प्रदीप सर प्लीज स्टार्ट आवर सेशन टुडे सर थैंक यू
गुड मॉर्निंग लर्नर्स टुडे वी स्टार्ट द ब्लॉक 4 ऑफ आवर कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशन इन अकाउंटिंग दैट इज मैनेजमेंट इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम सो मैनेजमेंट इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टू स्मूथ आवर एक्टिविटीज इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन
सर ऑडिबल खाली अल्प टिके वॉल्यूम बढ़ाई होबो कि टिके देखिले खाली
वॉल्यूम मे इंटररप्ट भावे सर
ओके सर सर
हां सर एक्चुअली हमर गुटिए क्लास कैंसिल हो जायथिला
ओके
हां तो एक्चुअली आज ही हमर मु जस्ट कहबी बोली भाबुथिले आपन को हमर मैनेजमेंट मैनेजमेंट इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम अछि आ डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट क्लास ता नेक्स्ट वीक को शिफ्ट हो गला जेतु फर्स्ट क्लास हमर कैंसिल हो जायथिला तो गुटी गुटी लेट रे हमें चली छे
ओके ओके
आगे 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 सर ओके सर ओके
सो ओके ठीक अछि तले ब्लॉक 4 टा को आज हमें कवर करिया
यस सर
ओके थैंक यू
सर सुबिना
ओके ओके यस सर ऑडिबल ऑडिबल सर ओके
ओके
यस सर ऑडिबल
ओके सर सर नाउ स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द मैनेजमेंट इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम First, we discuss about the basic concept of management information system. And management information system is an information system used for decision making and for coordination, control, analysis, and visualization of information in an organization. The study of management information systems involves people, process, and technology in an organizational context. However, in precise terms, Management Information System is a software system that focuses on the management of information technology to provide efficiency and effectiveness for strategic decision making. So important thing is that when we use the computerized management information system in our organization, it makes easier our daily task to making different decisions to communicate with our system and we need all the resources integrated through this management information system which generate quick response we generate quick solution to our problems okay then we come to the our basic concept the basic concept means The management information system is divided into three parts. We have this is a combination of three words. First one is the management, then information, then system. The three words having some distinct value in the concept of management information system. So first is management. So why we integrate the management information and system three words in management MIS. So the first management is. We will discuss about what is management. The management is the art of getting things done by others or done through others. That means the manager, what does is called management, and manager the involved in some activities in the organization is all about management. And there are different other concepts of management are also there, but we are not going to details like a. In management as a noun, management as a group, and management as a group to handle the group, to get the desired output. So it is a system where we engage in planning, organizing, directing, controlling, and coordinating. The second one is information. The information simply means processed data, or to in a layman language, data which can be converted into meaningful and useful form for a specific user. That is called information. Information is a processed data. That means which gives us some meaningful interpretation of that data. Then the last one is system. The system can be defined as a set of elements joined together for a common objective. System, here we system this computer system or computer and other equipments and human resources and other resources, other departments comes under in a system so that we communicate easily from one department to another department, flow of information and collecting feedbacks, etc. It comes under the whole management information system. So, Hujari sir, we continue with PPT or direct video?
Okay, sir.
Whether you continue PPT or like a simple video?
Okay, okay. PPT continuing is best, sir. PPT continuing.
Okay. So, first starting with our functions of management. We now presenting. Okay, so coming to the management, so we discuss now the functions of management, where the manager involved in an organization, what are the functions of that management. So the management functions starting with planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So always we found some specific, we use some specific functions in management to accomplish a specific task. So starting from, we start the management from planning. So what is planning? Now planning is the thinking in advance. We think about the future course of action by using planning. Then planning coordinate, planning decide about the future action, and it is a decision aspect of the management. So while we think about the organization, we first plan what to be do, what to be accomplished in the future course of action. Second, we come to the organizing. The organizing means the resources available within the organization, which come to a in the one basket, or we link all the resources available in the organization, so that we can get better effect. When the organizing is referred to two important things, one is the resources, another is the timing. So when we need those resources and we have to acquire that at that particular time period, so that we can assimilate or we can use the resources effectively in our organization. The next one is staffing. Staffing is the refers to the employee management, human resource management, recruitment, training, development of staff involved in the organization. Next, directing. Directing means to give the task, to give orders what the employees will perform in the organization. What are their tasks? What they do in the activities, the department, the party, put the right place, right people in right place, then we give the task to them, we give target to them, so that they can achieve the target within required resources effectively. The next one is controlling. Controlling means it is the most important aspect of management. The manager need to control whether our desired aspects or desired objectives, goals will be satisfied within the organization by using the different resources or not. So controlling is the, we see whether our standards or with the set standards in advance and the, we get the result, actual result, according to our standard or not. Okay, these are the functions of management. And next we discuss the second aspect, that is the levels of management. In each and every business organization, we found three levels of management. The one is top level, second middle level, and third is lower level. So when we discuss about the different levels of management, they have engaged in different tasks and they have different groups are also there. The task assigned to the top level managers, top level management, it is for setting objectives, planning, and policy making of the organization. And who are the top level managers or to top level management? They are generally board of directors, managing directors, chief executive officers. These are the, they set objectives, they set future plans, they prepare policies for the smooth running of the organization, for fulfillment of the goal or objectives of the organization. The second level is the middle level management. The middle level management are generally departmental heads. Departmental heads means the department, the different departments of the organization, like purchase department, like sales department, like finance department, having some one head, then they are called as managers. The managers like purchase manager, production manager, marketing manager, finance manager, the different managers are executing or implementing the plans formulated by the top level executives. The top level management create plans and that will be implemented by middle level management. They implement the policy which are formulated by the top level management in their respective departments. The respective departments means the purchase manager should implement that policy in purchase department, marketing manager implement in marketing management, marketing area or marketing department, so that we can get the better results by distributing the charges, distributing the activities of different group of managers in middle level management. The last one is the lower level management. So in lower level management, the people actually execute the policies, the object, the plans are implement, the plans are set by the top level management. So it is the lower level where the supervisors, foremen, daily workers are worked in the different department to produce product or to provide services. Then what they do? They execute the work and follow the rules and regulations. They execute the ground level work, and this is the most important level of management in the organization, because actually work is executed in the lower level management. So why we need this in information system? Now, before understanding the management information system, we should know the levels of management so that the communication flows from the top level to lower level and lower level to top level in a systematic way. So without having better knowledge in the management, it is difficult to understand the management information system. Next, data and information. First we discuss about the management, then you come to the information, then you come to the system. The data and information. Information is a processed data. So we found in raw form that is data. So what is data? Data refers to the facts or figures representing an object, place or the events occurring in the organization. Data processing. The data processing converts the raw data into a readable format that can be interpreted, analyzed, and used for a variety of purposes. Then information. The information, when data are processed, interpreted, organized, structured, or presented so as to make them meaningful or useful, they are called information. So information simply is a processed data which has some meaning, which we can understand by looking into the data. That is called information. but data is found in raw form that may be in any format. So we make them orderly form to make some meaningful interpretation of that data, that is called information. The characteristics of good information. So while the good data or good information having some characteristics. So part is relevance. Relevance means we have to some relevant data. Data relevant means, for example, if we want to judge the students' capability, the talent of students, so we may check the marks secured by them. We may check the IQ with them. So these are the relevant data. But if you go for judging the talent of a student, but we are looking about the dress, what is the cost of their dress, then that is not relevant to the talent. So that the data must be relevant to the present context, to the specific purpose for which we are analyzing data or for which we process the information. Next, accuracy. The data should be accurate. Without accurate data, it is very difficult to get accurate result. If your data is wrong, the result is wrong, because the machine is process it, or the anything, the methods or techniques process it, only use the formula to process. While the data is incorrect, the result is incorrect. So we first give importance about the result, about the data, which must be accurate data to be inputted in the system. Second, completeness. The data should be complete. The incomplete data could not give a complete meaning. The data must be complete. The total sample collected or total group of people from which we collect the data, we prepare the table, should be in complete nature. If the data are in gap, some data is not found, not available, then if one or two, it may make sense, but if more data are not available, then the result will be not give you proper process of proper information. Confidence in the source. Important then, the confidence in the source. Source is very important. From where you collect the data. Source, data source is very important part of the information system. While you collecting data, those who provide the data, the source of data should be authenticated. Because if with no authentication means, if you go for searching in Google, and many things are found in the Google. If you searching a word in Google, that may give many absurd results also. But you have to find out the authentic source, which is secured source or which is government source, which are data creating data, so that the data must be available from a definite source. We must confident on that source, that data is correct or data is perfect. The next is communication to the right person. So data communication is another subject or another characteristic of the good information. Then to whom data will be communicated. The communication, the language of communication, because when we communicate data, the data should be understood by the both communicator and communicator to whom the communication is made. So two parties both most understood the data in same meaning, not in different meaning. If you send data of anything and the receiving person understand in different way, then that information does not give you the satisfactory result. Then we discuss about the function of information. The functions of information. Also, first we discuss about the reduction of uncertainty. Information always works towards the reduction of uncertainty. More reduction of uncertainty, we go for progress towards certainty. Then, an aid to monitoring and control. The information, it works as a monitoring and control purpose. It gives more value to the control and monitoring, because without information, without data, we cannot control perfectly. We cannot monitor the system. The system is monitored with information only. Without any information, without any pre-set standards, without any objectives, without any goals, there is no control. Then, as means of communication, the information is also required as a means of communication. We communicate from one person to another person, one department to another department, top level to lower level, lower level to top level. The communication always needs some information. Without information, communication not possible. So information is a means of communication. As a memory supplement, and also information is needed, or our memory needed information. Without information, nothing to be kept, nothing to be captured by the memory, and it will be produced in future by the memory. So memory needs some information for processing to get the desired result. Next, it adds to simplification. Next one is the information should be simplified, at which gives us the simplification process by reducing large data or large information into a small one, and which can be easily understood by minimizing the overload of information, overload of data by using information. Next come to information system. So information system, then information system can be any organized combination of people, hardware, software, communication software, and data resource that collects transformation or cleaning the information in an organization. So system, when integrated with information, that become information system. The system is, I've already told you that system is the combination of people, hardware, software, or people, system, and communication. The communication software, data, resource, that collects transformation or streaming of information in organization, whole is called the information system. Then we complete our information, and there is also components of information are there. Different components like people, resources, data resources, software resources, hardware resources, and network resources. These are the component of the information system. The information system is integration of information and system. So to communicate information, to flow information in a systematic way, we need system. So system is included people, data, software, hardware, network, and all are combined together to make it the meaningful information system. So where people are the end users, those who are using data, using information. Information system specialists, those who are maintaining the information system, flow of information in the system. Data resource is understood by database, knowledge base. Software resource, like program and procedure involved or installed in the hardware to process our data, to make the meaningful information, to make the information used for decision making purpose. Hardware resource is machine, media. Machine means we use computer, laptop, printer, and data connection, like media is data connection, internet connection, LAN, WAN, different media are there so that we communicate data from one place to another place. And also network resources also internet system, or the LAN one also comes within that system. So these are the components of information system, and information system gives us the smooth flow of the information from one place to another place. The next we come to the system. We have discussed management, then information, then we come to the system. So what is system? A system is a group of interrelated components working together towards a common goal by accepting inputs, and producing outputs in an organized transformation process. Okay, so it is a interrelated components of different resources. Then we use them to get the desired result or to satisfy our, to achieve our objectives, achieve our goals. So in system or in system, what are the elements? So we found the element of a system. So first one is technology. The technology is a computer network. Technology use the computer network. A computer network are systems of information processing components that are a variety of hardware, software, and telecommunication technology. So under technology system, we use hardware, software, and telecommunication like a computer, printers, monitors, computer monitor, CPU, etc., etc., hardware. Software, we use the application software to process our data, and the telecommunication technology to transfer data or to communicate data from one place to another place, to, from one department to another department, from one person to another person. Second, application. The application, under application, element of application, that electronic business and commerce application involves interconnected business information system. The application is very important in a system. Without proper application, the information may not be processed. It is an interconnected system. Then development. The development is the way to use IT in the business, include designing the basic component of the information system. Development means always we need to develop our system, develop our information technology as to cope with the present market condition, to cope with the present situation by developing our system, developing our technology, etc. The next is another one is the management. The managing IT emphasizes the quality, strategy, business value, and security of an organization in an information system. So these are the various elements of a component system. When you come to the components of system, the system inputs something, processes something, and outputs something. It is a combination of three important aspects: input, process, output. The input involves capturing and assembling elements that enter into the system to be processed. Some of the inputs are raw material, energy, data, etc. So while in a system we input something, system processes it by using technology, by using applications. Processing either involves transformation of process that converts input to output. Okay. It, while you computer, the processing unit is there, the CPU, central processing unit, while you input some data in Excel chart or in Word, then that processes the data and gives us the output. Output will need for future reference, and output gives us the meaning of the meaningful use of the data. Then output is the inverse transforming elements that has been produced by transformation process to their ultimate destination. That means output gives us a system which are used by the users of the processing data, users of the information. So the output may be in different form, may be in subcopy, may be for in a printing of that data, may be used for the decisioning purpose in different manner. So three important component of a system: it collects data through input system, it processes data, and it gives output for the use of the organization. Then you come to the types of system. Okay, types of system. First one is the dynamic system. The dynamic system, when the interrelated components of the system interacts with each other and these controlled by management, then it is known as dynamic system. interrelated components of the system. It means the components, those components are interrelated. They are controlled by the management, and the dynamic means it is changing. In the changing environment, the system is changed by using different aspects of the resources, different aspects of the interact with the different components, then that is called dynamic system. Cybernetic system, the dynamic system implementing the concept of feedback and control is known as cybernetic system. Control, concept of feedback and control. Now, when we use the system for control purpose by using feedback, okay, feedback, you know, the feedback means and feedback and from the users, from the ultimate users of the information, ultimate users of the product. Sometimes the organization collect the feedback from the customer, whether their product, whether their services satisfy the customers or not. While we taking implementing some projects, implementing some new policies, the top management collect feedback from the lower level management, whether this policy, these methods work correctly or not. So feedback, when used in controlling purpose, that is called cybernetic system. Then open system got interact with other system in its environment by exchanging input and output with its environment. The open system is no restriction. While interaction is open and the environment, whole environment are exchanging their input and output among themselves to complete an open system. Another is adaptive system. The adaptive system having the ability to change itself and its environment in order to survive is called the adaptive system. The adaptive system adapts itself in the changing environment. So environment, generally we discuss about the technological environments and the competitive environment where the system is cope with the present environment. It may change itself by increasing the adaptability and increasing the technology to increase, like if you are our TV, that due to change in the development of the new system, innovative ideas like our convert from the black and TV to color TV, color TV to our LED, LCD, LED, etc., 4K, 4K, etc. So the technology, our technology should cope with that. So when we should not stick up with a old technology, old system. So we upgrade our system, which may be survive in the existing business environment. Then we discuss the role of information system in business. Why we need information system in business? That it support the business process. The business process make easier by using the information system. It support operation of a business organization. Business organization operated very easily by using information system. The operation cannot be cope with the existing environment without using of information system. That if there is no communication made by the top level executive, the middle level to the lower level, there is a problem of operation of the business. So the system, information system helps the business for operating in effective and efficiently. Let's support decision making. The decision making of an organization of a business needs support of data, support of information. Without information, not take decisions. The decision is the most important area of a organization, of an activity. In each and every activity, we need good decision making capacity. Without having good decision, you may suffer loss, you may failure in the business, you may failure in the activities. But how you take a decision? Now you need some information, some data, some alternative choice, so that you can analyze them and you will take good decisions. Strategy for an organization. Strategy means the way the pathway by which we get the success. We think in advance, or we create our plan so that we make with achieve success in the organization. That is the strategy. Next, we come to the unit 2. The unit 1 almost complete. And now we come to the unit 2. That is the management information system application in organization. So first, in first unit, we have discussed the meaning of the information system. Management information system, that the management information and system, and we aggregate them to find out what is management information system. Now we get to how management information system apply in the organization and what are its benefits in the organization. Okay, so management information system is certainly known as the MIS, MIS. Applications in organization. First, we go to the concept. We have already discussed about the concept of information. Next, we again repeat it. The data is a raw material for the information system. Data is processed to create information and used by managers to initiate action and to run the organization efficiently. So again, we come to that concept. The data is processed to create information, and information is required by managers to initiate action, to make decisions, to organize business, organize the business effectively and efficiently. Okay, so now we discuss what are the different types of information used in the business. So now we implement the want to know the implementation of management information system in the business organization. Okay, so first types of information, strategic information. The strategic information needed for long range planning and directions, and this is less structured. The long term planning, long term directions are called strategic information. Tactical information, the tactical information needed to take short-range decisions to improve profitability and performance. The first is the strategic information needed for the long-range planning. That means in long run, business interested to grow and to initiate the growth and expansion of the business for future time. That is the strategic decision. But in tactical decision, we need short-range decisions to improve the profitability and performance. Performance means to increase sales, to make generate more and more profit. This is the short-term objectives of a business. Then operational information needed for day-to-day operation of the organization. Like when we work in the organization, we go to the day-to-day performance, like daily work, daily sales, daily purchases, billing, payment of salary, payment of other expenses. So these are the comes under the operational information. Statutory information. The statutory information gives us the which is needed by law to send to government authorities. The informations are sent to the government authorities regarding the income tax, regarding the sales tax, regarding the duties, different duties generated by the business or given by the business, paid by business. These are comes under the statutory, which needed by law. Okay, so these are the four types of information available in the organization, and we need to process or to check these information to take different decisions. Then information for management. So what is management? We will discuss what is management. Management is getting things done for others. So management aspects in मैनेजमेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ ए बिजनेस इंक्लूड्स प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट, मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट, मटेरियल मैनेजमेंट, फाइनेंस मैनेजमेंट, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट, ऑपरेशन मैनेजमेंट, मेनी मोर. सो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द नेचर ऑफ बिजनेस वी यूज डिफरेंट मैनेजमेंट एस्पेक्ट इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. वेयर प्रोडक्शन इज देयर, वेयर इंडस्ट्री इज देयर, वी यूज प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट. द प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट ऑल्सो हैविंग डिफरेंट इंफॉर्मेशन लाइक स्ट्रेटेजिक, टेक्टिकल, ऑपरेशनल इंफॉर्मेशन ऑल्सो अवेलेबल इन द प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट. जनरली इंडस्ट्रीज आर यूज प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट. द मेथड्स अप्लाइड इन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स आर इंक्लूडेड इन द प्रोडक्शन मैनेजमेंट. मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट, दैट मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट शोज अस हाउ टू इंक्रीज सेल्स. व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट मेथड्स ऑफ एडवर्टाइजमेंट वी यूज एंड व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम फेस टू द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फेस ड्यूरिंग इट्स मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट. मटेरियल मैनेजमेंट रेफर्स टू स्टॉक, परचेज ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल, एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल, व्हेन टू परचेज, व्हेयर टू परचेज, हाउ मच टू परचेज, दीज आर द डिसीजन अंडर मटेरियल मैनेजमेंट. फाइनेंस मैनेजमेंट, हाउ मच मनी टू इन्वेस्ट एंड व्हेन टू इन्वेस्ट एंड व्हेयर टू बोरो, दीज आर डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट. And human resource management, the most important part, but it is neglected by any business. Human resource management is considered the human resource, because the human is without human being, without employee, business cannot run. Very important part. And the satisfaction of human being, satisfaction of the employee, is the core part of the management. Without satisfactory environment, the human resource could not work efficiently in an organization. So, and the most important aspect of the information management is human resource, because human can understand the information and they take decisions. Everything is related to human resource in management information system. Now discuss the information system through computer. A computer-based information system. The computer-based information system is application of computer in our information system, in our management information system. So there are different aspects of computer-based information system. The first one is transaction processing system. So what is transaction processing system? A transaction processing system is a type of information system that collects, stores, modifies, and retrieves the data transaction of an enterprise. So, transaction processing system processes the information system where they collect, store, modify the data. The data transactions like a business purchase, sales, go for selling of goods, purchase of goods, employee administration, payment of salaries, many things, many data are there. And we first collect them from the record source with evidence, then we store them, then we modify as per our requirement, then we retrieve the data for the use of the management. It is called transaction processing. So we process the transactions. Like if you go for processing transactions of final account, then you need some software like Tally, ERP, you can use that to process the data to get the profit and loss of the business and balance sheet of the business at the end of the year. Next, management information system. This is a management information system is a computer system consisting of hardware, software, and serves as the backbone of the organization operation. We know the management information system supply the information from the source to the destination where the information is required, and it should be generated from the information where it is generated. So it flow of information from one place to another place by using the hardware, software, and other resources required in the system. Next one is the decision support system. This is also an important part of the computer-based information system. A decision support system is a computerized program used to support determination, judgment, and course of action in an organization. The judgment or a decision, while taking a decision, something to be supported to get a good decision. So here is the decision support system, which is the computer program, which screen the data, interpret the data, create judgments, and we take the course of action by deciding new decisions from the process data. Next is office automation system. Office automation system is the administration side of a business need for the manipulating the data and information to process the data, to store the data of the office. So electrically or manually, regard office automation system. So in office automation system, we are using computer. The computer based information system that collects, process, store, transmits electronic messages, documents, other form of communication system among the work groups, individuals, and the organization. So office use the office automation system. Decision making management use the decision support system. Information required in management, information required in whole organization, and transition processing system required to process the transition in the organization. These are the most important part of a computer based information system. We need this system for processing information effectively. Okay, again we come to the management information system. This is the part of our application in the business. Where the management information system is a system which provides precise, timely, and meaningful data for management planning, analysis, and control to optimize the growth of the organization. Okay, already we have discussed it for the management information system. Then objective of management information system in an organization. That means business or organizational use of management information system. So what we do with management information system in an organization? First one is the data capturing. The data capturing means to input data, or when you capture data, we input in the system. The management information system capture data from various internal and external sources of the organization. The data capturing may be manual or through computer terminals. That means when we found manual data, we enter it into the computer, make it technical data, or we may collect directly data through the computer terminals, from the internet source, from the any other source, like we may record voice recording, video recording. We are directly through computer terminals, and if we use manual data by typing from different source, from the different vouchers or different documents, then that is called manual data input in the computer database. That is called data capturing. Processing of data. Then after capturing data and enter the data into the computer system or the management information system, then the computer processes the data. The captured data is processed to convert into required information, desired information. Okay, processing of data is done by such activities as calculating, sorting, classifying, and summarizing. We use first to record the data, then that we process data by classifying them as per their suitability, sorting them depending upon their common features. Then we summarize them to make a meaningful result. Storage of information. After processing data, we store that information. After processing the data converted into information, then we use the information word, storage of information. The information storage stored in the computer system, in the memory chip, or external hard disk. For what? Now, for फ्यूचर यूज फॉर कम्युनिकेटिंग टू अदर्स इन ए नेटवर्क और थ्रू अदर मीन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. इफ एनी इंफॉर्मेशन इज नॉट इमीडिएटली रिक्वायर्ड, इट इज सेव्ड फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रिकॉर्ड, सेव्ड फॉर एज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल रिकॉर्ड फॉर लेटर यूज फॉर फ्यूचर यूज. सो इंफॉर्मेशन शुड बी स्टोर्ड effectively for future need. While we need for in future historical data, we use the data in future for taking decisions. Retrieval of information. The retrieval means after storage, when we need it, we have to retrieve the data. The MIS retrieves information from its stores as and when required by various users. When the users need the old data, the historical data which are saved before, then we retrieve them for the present use or the use in decision making process. Next one is the dissemination of information, the distribution of information. The dissemination of information which is finished product of MIS. The MIS, the finished product is information or the results or the decision which are taken from the processed information that the users of the data, users of the information need that information for the decision making purpose, so that the organization distribute that information to the needy people, those who are required for the data, not to other people, those who are linked with the organization. Like the data, like your profit loss data could be communicated to the government, so what is the income they will calculate. Like our product information should be communicated to the customers, how to use them, how to get various benefits, various services of that product, that should be known by the customer. So we communicate that data to the customer, to the shareholders, to the employees, to suppliers, to many persons, to banks, many persons are there, many institutions are there. Those who are using our information, using the related information of the organization, so that we communicate the data from the management information system to the needy people. Characteristics of management information system in an organization. So we have already discussed the characteristics, but here the organizational based management information system. The first one is the system approach. The management information system is related to the systems approach. We use the system in transmitting the information, in using dissemination of information, using information, processing information. So it is a systematic system approach. We are using system to process the information. Management oriented. This management information system is always management oriented. That means the management, different levels of management, like the advantages of this system, of this management information system, to generate maximum benefit for the decision making purpose, for the control purpose, for the organizing purpose, from that information. Need based means the management information system provides numerous information, many informations, and that informations are not needed, all informations may not be needed by one management, one department, one person. So they, depending upon the need, they extract the data or they extract the information from the system. Like the sales personnel, sales managers need what is the advertisement expenses, what is the area for operation or area for selling of the products, what are the transportation facilities, like your other warehousing facilities, other required information by a sales manager, by a marketing manager. But finance manager thinks other things. फाइनेंशियल मैनेजर नीड्स व्हाट इज द इंटरेस्ट रेट करेंट मार्केट व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ आवर फाइनेंस फॉर फ्यूचर एक्सपेंशन फ्यूचर डेवलपमेंट दे थिंक अबाउट दैट एक्सेप्शन राइट दे ऑलवेज बेस्ड ऑन द एक्सेप्शंस नेक्स्ट फ्यूचर ओरिएंटेड ऑलवेज द नीड management information system is future oriented. We take decision for future by using the past data. It is integrated approach. Integrated means it is a combination of people, system and technology. The technology, people, system, sabbu ko mishai kari ame we prepare management information system. So it is an integrated approach. Integrated system. Common data flow. The data is flow very common. The common data flow is used by the management information system and we maintain the systematic flow, smooth flow of the data in a general way. Next is long-term planning. Always we use management information system for long-term planning. We also use it in short-term planning, but long-term planning is the most important part than the short-term planning. In business for growth and revival. Next, subsystem concept. Sometimes we use subsystems in management information system to support effective data, correct data collected from the different subsystems, and we are integrating that subsystem to the main system to find out the desired result. Okay. Then central database. The database of the management information system should be designed centrally, where all the subsystems, concepts, subsystems data are integrated and become the main database, where all the data are stored systematically. When we come to the role of management information system in an organization. The system ensures that an appropriate data is collected from the various sources, processed and sent further to all the needy destinations. The second role is the management information system satisfies the diverse needs through a variety of systems, such as theory system, analysis system, modeling system, and decision support system. Next, the management information system helps the clerical personnel in the transaction processing and answer their queries on the data pertaining to the transaction. Next, the management information system helps the middle management in short term planning, target setting and controlling the business functions. The next, the management information system plays the role of information generation, communication, problem identification, and helps in the process of decision making. So these are the most important role of management information system in an organization. Now with this, we complete our unit 2. Next, we come to the unit 3, where we discuss about the management information system issues and challenges. The management information system, again we discuss, it is all about collecting and processing of raw data into useful information and its dissemination to the users at various levels of management. In the required format, it produces information which impacts management to understand the business situation of the organization and take decision accordingly. So this is all about the meaning of our concept of management information system. Next, we discuss about the various issues and challenges of computerized management information system. The first we discuss again the characteristics of computerized management information system. The computerized management information system uses computer in its system to process the data, to transmit data, to disseminate data, we need the computer, so that it is called computer management information system. So what is the basic characteristics? First, it should be able to process data accurately and with high speed using various techniques. The computer management system processes data accurately and with high speed using various techniques, various softwares. Because it is difficult to process data quickly and accurately, so manual system is very difficult. Second, it should be able to collect, organize, manipulate, and update large amount of raw data. While we use computer information system, computer management information system, we can able to collect, organize, and manipulate a large amount of data, large amount of raw data, because it processed systematically in a short period of time with a mouse click through the computer. While in a manual system, it is very difficult to organize a large amount of data in a short period of time, so that we use computer management information system. Next, it should provide real-time information on ongoing events without any delay. So while we use computer information system, it helps us to provide the real-time information. Real-time information means when we need, we get the data. When we get, for example, if we process the business transactions like journal ledgers and trial balance, and when we click on any time of the year, we can get the final account. So that gives us the immediately. But in manual system of accounting, we need many things. We have to total ledger accounts, transfer that to the trial balance, then we prepare final accounts. It takes many times to process the data. But computer account system or computer information system or accounting system gives us the result in a single click. It should support various output formats and follow latest rules and regulations in practice. So computerized management information system adapted itself by using the environmental aspects. The environmental aspects of new developments. Anything developed, anything new technology are available in the market, available in the country. The system or management information system of our organization always cope with that by using the latest technology. So its format always found in different manner. Something it may be in print manner if the information can be processed and we can get the printout copy. We can take in pen drive, we can take in CD, we can take in floppy disk, like that. The different medium used to get the result in different formats. So which is supported by the latest rules and regulations in practice. There will be latest rules and regulations in the market, then the computer management information system support that format and provide the data in that format. The next is, it should provide organized and relevant information for all levels of management, like strategic, operational, and tactical. The strategy for long-term process and the tactical for the short-term, and operational for the continuous process in the organization. For all these purposes, the management information system provides the information or need for the all level, like middle top level, middle level, and lower level of management. Next, it should aim at extremely flexibility in data storage and retrieval. Flexibility in data storage. Data storage means we can store many data, a huge, large quantity data in computer which cannot be stored in manual system, which require many space, 10, 100, 12, 100, 1000 books to be recorded, but it can be presented in a 1 or 2 sheets of a database system. All the data is there available, and it can be retrievable easy. You can search and you can find what you search. You can go for search command and you can search the relevant data and you can retrieve it with extreme flexibility, which cannot be able in manual system of data storage or manual system of information system. Functions of management information system. So what are the main important functions of management information system? Data capturing. We have already discussed in advance, but this is the real-time requirement of the organization or the organizational point of view to discuss this management information system. The same functions also we have discussed earlier. The data capturing, which is a short discussion. Data capturing means to capture the data, processing of data, storage of information, retrieval of information, dissemination of information. All these points we have discussed earlier, so there is no need to further discussion. Next, the role of management information system in the business organization. So this is the organizational role. When we use management information system in our business for different purpose. What mentioned here is that 4 items, but actually it used in many occasions, many requirements we need management information system. The most important is here we produce that this is the decision making. Decision making is the important part of a business. What decision you take and when to take and with the decision making making process which enables a business to progress to achieve the goal within a limited time period. So decision making needed many data so that from the alternative data, you can take decision for the future. The management information system helps to retrieve the data, to analyze the data, to disseminate the data, to get the real-time decision in the organization. Second, it coordinates among the departments. Information system is primarily required for coordination. Without information, there is no coordination. There is a harmonic relation in an organization prevails due to communication of information system systematically and timely. Then the control, the management information system coordinates among the departments. That may be electronic communication, maybe manual communication. The communication helps us to know about the different activities of different department. We go for directing about the activities of different department. Direction, order are given by the top of authority to the lower level authority, delegates the power, then take the feedback from the lower level manager, lower level managers or lower level workers. What is the real-time problems with them? So that they may be, so that may be solved by using the communication system. Without communication, the higher authority or the lower level workers could not communicate, then there is nothing could be possible. If the top level cannot solve the problem of the lower level, or the lower level cannot get the direction from the top level. So it is a coordination among department can be possible by using management information system. So next is finding out solution to the problems. While there is a problem, it should be found out by using the information system, because we can communicate with the people, those who can provide the solution to our problem. We can communicate our problem first, then the problem area is communicated among the people that can be solved by any of them by using the different methods, techniques by different employees. Comparison of business performance. So another role of management information management information system is that it compares the business performance. We can go for horizontal comparison, vertical comparison. We can compare from the past data, the past year progress and the current year progress. Or we can compare our business with the similar types of business of the other organization. Then if we avail the information, then we can compare. Without information, we cannot compare. The past year data, if not available, we cannot compare it with the current year data. If the others company, others similar types of company data are not available, then we cannot compare with them. Okay, that both the horizontal comparison, vertical comparison can be possible by using the management information system. Otherwise, it is very difficult. Benefits of management information system. So what are the benefits we get by using management information system in our organization? The first one is it helps to achieve a higher level of efficiency. The efficiency and effectiveness can be achieved by management information system, which reduces the wastage, which reduces the idle time in the organization and increase productivity. Second, it improves the quality of decision. The decision quality, the real-time decision and the perfect decision. The decision depending upon the needs of the time is very important for an organization. So while the quality of decision improves, the organization itself improves. So it is very important to take quality decision by using management information system. Next, it improves better communications between departments in a workplace. Generally, while using computerized management information system, it increases the better communication. But sometimes we use the manual communication system, but at present, different quick communication communication system like mobile phone, like internet. It increases the communication ability of the organization. We reduce the time and we can communicate very easily from one place to another by calling, by voice call, by video call, everything. By internet system, we can communicate others. So departmental communication, if that workplace is from a different department having a distance place, the duration watching, again we can also communicate in better way by using management information system in the organization. Next, it provides a platform to explore different scenario for various alternative and economic environments. The management information system provides a platform then which gives us the alternative choice, alternative environments, economic environment, which can help to progress of the organization of the specific organization or the particular organization. Next, it strengthens a company's competitive advantages. The using management computerized management information system increases the company's competitive advantages. It becomes more competitive while we use management information system and we solve the problems immediately, we take quick decision, we communicate quickly, then it increases the competitiveness of the organization. It improves employee productivity. The employee's productivity also increase by using management information system because it communicates information quickly to the employees. Like if any opportunity comes to the employees, any order from the top authorities to execute work, any rewards given to the employees by increasing the productivity, efficiency, then automatically the employees increase their productivity by by full satisfaction of their work environment. If their work environment is bhalo tabre kaam kari parle bhalo information they get information agent when required, then automatically their productivity increases. It reveals more data about performance. Then again, the management information system facilitates the data which cannot be possible in manual system accounting, manual system of information management. So when we collect, at present, you know that the customers, when you purchase something, and jab bhi kinhi logo jao jo, then they ask what is your mobile number. That means they print the data, they capture the data and kept in their management information system, so that they can send message, they can send advertisement, many things. They track customer, how much that customer purchase. Then many things can be managed easily through management information system, which reveals the data about customer, the real-time requirement, and that is stored in the system, database management system. Okay. Next we come to the limitations or disadvantages. The limitations also there, everything having some limitations, disadvantages, but where the advantages is more, we assume that that is a better thing. There are advantages, but we could not say that there is no limitations in a system. But a system, not a concept or limitations, we cannot say it. The limitations of MIS, why? It requires constant monitoring. So we have to follow, we have to check the management information system, computer management information system always constantly, so that it gives us the better result. Budgeting of management information system is extremely difficult. While we invest or while we need management information system computer, these are, we talk about the computer management information system. Using computer and various modems and different equipments for smooth flow of the management information system, we need more budget. We use many financial hurdles. We use finance for getting the smooth flow of the management information system. If we have lack of money, shortage of finance, it is difficult to manage management information system. Lack of flexibility to update it. The quality of output depends upon the quality of inputs. Everywhere, we have already talked about that the input, the output result depends upon input. The quality, if the quality of input is bad, quality of input is erroneous, then we must get the erroneous output. So while anything wrong is entered into the system, that gives us, that makes all system erroneous. So generally, management information, while in maintaining management information system, we take care of that. While entering the data, while input the data, we should take care of that. We should give the correct and reliable information. Lack of flexibility to update it. Generally, sometimes we cannot update occasionally when there is a new technology comes into our technological world. Then, if we convert it, it needs huge expenditure, it needs huge budget. So, it is lack of flexibility to update. We cannot update as quickly as possible, as quickly as the technology updates. Like if you have a fax machine, and you need convert into immediately come to the computer system, emailing system, then email system, immediate system. Then you have to if you convert immediately, you need some huge investment. And again, we cannot update as per the market technology, technological market. Technology market is update hoji, sathya sigra hame update kari kari wana. Kahenge, now we need huge amount to update our present system. Takes into account only qualitative factor. Generally, the management information system टेक ओनली अकाउंट ऑफ क्वालिटेटिव फैक्टर जनरली इट कुड नॉट इन्वॉल्व वी कैन नॉट यूज द नॉन क्वालिटेटिव फैक्टर लाइक क्वांटिटी नॉट नॉन क्वालिटेटिव फैक्टर लाइक द मोरल मोरल ऑफ द माने द साइकोलॉजी ऑफ द पर्सन साइकोलॉजी ऑफ एम्प्लॉई मोरल ऑफ एम्प्लॉईज स्पेसिफिक एम्प्लॉईज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन देयर प्रॉब्लम्स दैट कैन नॉट बी जज इन द मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम इट इज अ कॉस्टली अप्रोच जनरली स्मॉल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कैन नॉट अफोर्ड इट एज इट इज रिक्वायर्ड ह्यूज इन्वेस्टमेंट नेक्स्ट इट कुड नॉट मीट द स्पेशल डिमांड ऑफ ईच पर्सन इट कुड नॉट मीट द स्पेशल डिमांड ऑफ ईच पर्सन तो इट इज अ सिस्टम मैनेजमेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन सिस्टम we cannot identify the single people single employees demand single employee problem we cannot solve easily in case of management information system we are a first integrated approach is continuing then we discuss the challenge of management information system the basic challenges of management information systems are in your book you have three category of three factors of it classify the challenges in three different part like your humanity factor organization factor and energy factor but as a whole the basic challenges of management information system are lack of strategy generally if we have lack of strategy we don't have any long term strategy long term objective so we cannot use management information system systematically in a business organization meeting organization need so meeting organizational need organize what organizational needs and why what we can provide that is the important gap between the management information computer management information system and the manual management information system attracting and retaining top talent the efficient people attracting them is a difficult task and also retaining them in the organization is also a difficult task at talent market environment because competition is there everywhere people if they are more talented they ask more money more salary and if we could not fulfill their expectation then they left the organization so it is very difficult to keep the top talented talents in the organization for a long period of time keeping up with change generally the change it is a challenge for the management information system to upgrade as per the changes made in the environment the technological environment always changing in nature always the new things new systems new softwares come in the market after a such interval so which cannot be updated by the organization those who implement their management information system in a short range and could not be upgraded with a huge loss if you upgrade it it becomes huge cost for the organization so it is difficult to keep up with change in a real time manner integrating new technology another the new technology arrival in the management support system management information system it is difficult to integrate because already a system is ready and you work in a system and you adopt any new technology adopt any new system to that to the existing system then that create disruption or create different result or the manner to be observed measures understood by the users of the information at present next further these are the basic challenges and you can group in different like your humanistic factor organizational factor and environmental factor in the books you get the details what I want to discuss meeting with humanistic factor organizational factor and environmental factor okay then it is the lack of specific information lack of understanding of the needs of the users likewise you have to discuss it then you want to come to the challenges of management information system challenges various how there are different factors we want to discuss it security the security of management information system the technology is now is very community, when we use the technology, it may be hacked by the various people for the use of that information. So protection of information, protection of confidential information in the organization is very important. So preventing the unauthorized individuals or system from accessing the information, maintaining and assuring the accuracy and consistency of data over life cycle, it is a difficult task to maintain the assuring the accuracy of the data, ensuring the data, transaction, communications or documents are genuine, ensuring the integration of transactions by validating that both parties involved are genuine by incorporating authentication features such as digital signatures. So while you collecting data, whether that data is correctly correct or not, whether for persons providing the data is authentic or not, it also authenticated by the digital signatures. Safeguarding data, communication, stored and shared network system is also important part of the security of this management system. Without a proper security, if the data is communicated to other person, data leaked, then there is a problem faced by the organization, rather used by unauthorized person of our data in the system. Then some code of ethics, the professional conduct in management information system. Generally, the code of ethics, your code of conduct is very important to maintain a systematic management information system. The first one is to strive to achieve the highest quality, effectiveness, and dignity in both the process and products of professional work. It acquires and maintains professional competencies, know and respect existing laws pertaining to the professional work, accept and provide appropriate professional review, give comprehensive and broad evaluation of computer system and their impacts, including analysis and possible risks, honor contracts, agreements, and assigned responsibilities, improve public understanding of computing and its consequences, access computing and communication resources only when authorized to do so. Thank you. This is the end of your question.
Okay. Thank you, Pradeep sir. Very nice class. Today class is very nice. Our only morning, one and
some
two.
More energy than the evening.
Sir, many only one or two learners available here now. So I request, name is Saudamini Nayak. Please, any questions, please directly ask to our resourcers.
Okay, you unmute the microphone and ask question.
Saudamini Nayak, please unmute your microphone and any questions, please ask to directly, sir.
सर नमस्कार सर मो स्त्री रो मोबाइल डायवर्ट करके देखु सर मोर नंबर टा
थैंक यू मो नाटा जानि परोनी तनो नेम टा कहू ओके
मो ना रमणी रंजन नायक सर बालीमला इंडस्ट्री टा कर सर
ओके ओके रमणी बाबू वेरी नाइस
हां सर
प्लीज एनी हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस प्लीज आस्क टू प्रदीप सर
सर मैं नेक्स्ट क्लास में पता रही सर अभी
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
So today our session is closed here, sir. Thank you, Pradeep, sir.
Thank you.
ক্লাস ରମଣୀ ବାବୁ କହିଲେ
କୋଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ପଚାରିଲେନି
ଏଇଟା ମୁଢି କହୁ କି ଆଉ କଣ ହବ ଆରେ ମୋ ଫଟୋଟା ଏବେ କୋହଲା ଦେହ ଯାଇଛି ହେଲେ ଜାଗା ତାଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଆଲୋଚନା ହବ
କଣଟା